डियर स्टूडेंट्स नाम वीडियो पाकपो प्लस टू फिजिक्स तमिलनाडु स्टेट बोर्ड फर्स्ट चैप्टर एलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स इतवरी चेनल सब्सक्राइब सब्सक्राइब नाम पाता वीडियो डाइइलेक्ट्रिक इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड व्हेन द बैटरी इज डिस्कनेक्टेड दैट वी हैव स्टडीड एंड ऑब्टेन्ड एन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द एनर्जी यू दैट इज गिवन बाय यू इक्वल टू यू नॉट बाय epsilon r. Now in this video we are going to study about the case when the battery remains connected to the capacitor. So when the battery is connected to the capacitor and when we introduce the dielectric, what happens? That we will see here. For this we consider that the battery is connected to the capacitor and the dielectric is inserted, that is as shown in the diagram. Here, so in this case you see that the parallel plate capacitor is connected to the battery and here there is no dielectric. Now you are introducing the dielectric between the two plates even if the battery is connected to the plates. So for this you consider the potential difference that is given by V naught across the plates, that will remain constant. So, but it is found experimentally that when the dielectric is inserted, the charge stored in the capacitor is increased by a factor of epsilon r. That we already seen. That therefore, the equation for the charge stored by the capacitor is given by Q equal to epsilon r times Q naught. That is equation 1.97, and due to this increased charge, the capacitance is also increased. Therefore, the new capacitance is given by the expression C equal to Q by V naught, and that's equal to epsilon R Q naught by V naught. That's equal to epsilon R times C naught. That is 1.98, and the reason for the increase in capacitance is when the battery remains connected. That is different from the case when the battery is disconnected before you introduce the dielectric. Therefore, the expression for the capacitance is given by C naught equal to epsilon naught A by D. This is before we introduce the dielectric, and after the introduction of the dielectric, the capacitance is given by C equal to epsilon A by D, that's 1.99. And the energy stored in the capacitor before the insertion of a dielectric, that's given by U naught equal to half C naught V naught square. That's equation 1.100, and here we have not used the expression U naught equal half Q naught square by C naught, because here the charge and capacitance are changed, whereas in the equation 1.100 V naught remains constant. So to get an expression for the energy after the dielectric is introduced, the capacitance will be increased, as you know, and the stored energy is also increased. So U equal to half C V naught square, and that's equal to half epsilon R C naught V naught square. That's equal to epsilon R times U naught. That equation 1.101. Since the relative permittivity epsilon R is greater than 1, we have U also greater than U naught. So it is noted here that since the voltage between the capacitor V naught is constant, the electric field between the plates also remains constant. The energy density is given by the expression U equal to half epsilon E naught square, that's 1.102, where this epsilon is the permittivity of a given dielectric material. And the results of these two discussions, they are summarized in the tabular column. This is the tabular column. I explained when the battery is disconnected, what happens to the charge, the voltage, electric field, capacitance, and energy. for the two cases when the battery is disconnected and when the battery is connected. Now, in the first case, when the battery is disconnected, the charge Q remains constant, voltage decreases, electric field decreases, capacitance increases, and energy decreases. Whereas when the battery is connected, the charge Q increases, voltage remains constant, electric field remains constant, capacitance increases, and the energy increases. So, we will study about the next topic in our next video. Thank you.